Hi, how are you? This is my first video on You Are Loved. I was just on my way to Snoodlesburg, the home of the Snoodles. And you know what? I was talking to them and I learned so much. That's why I've got my backpack today. Because I was thinking about what makes me me. There's no one in the world like me. Might have similar things, ways of thinking alike, but we are different and that makes us special. So I decided to put on my backpack some of the things that I like the most. Those things that make me feel happy, in peace, and they're part of my life and I would like to share them with you. Well, the first thing I'm gonna take is a hat. Why do I choose a hat? Because I like to make believe. I like to create stories, get into character, and I don't know, tell you a story, pretend I'm a detective. Yeah, that's why I've got my hat. Well, then I've got a book. You know what? Because I really, really, really like to tell stories, especially to children. I like to explain everything that is inside of it and give you a little bit of my own imagination so you can understand and you can read it with me even if you're very far, far away from me. So a book, that's part of who I am and the things I like to do. Then I've got colors. Watercolor pastels. Those are my favorite. First of all, they have the most amazing colors. But besides, when we go to mix them together, we can make new colors and draw all sorts of beautiful paintings and pictures. And I really like to draw. So I've got my watercolor. Okay, then, well, this is more or less the same, but then I've got some streamers because I love to dance, Yeah, I want you to know. So I've got my streamers because I really enjoy dancing. And what else? What else? Oh, yeah. And I've got my brush and I've got my painting. I really like to do some face painting. Again, probably because of the same thing. I like to get into character mode and I paint myself. I'm just gonna do this little heart. I really enjoy doing it when I'm telling my stories. And you know what? Oh, today is all about you are loved. So I can do my little heart in here to remind us how much we are loved. All of us, you too, we are loved. So here it is. And I think that's all. Oh, and I didn't bring it. Well, because it wouldn't fit my bag, but I've got something else. Wait a second. Okay, this is a big one. One, two, three. Yes, that's my guitar because I really, really like music. I love to sing, to dance, like I told you, and to play instruments, musical instruments. That's something else I like to do. And it's not just about what we like, it's about what makes us feel happy. And when we do it, it seems easy because it's called a gift. It's a gift. That's why I believe that all of us in the entire world, including you, we have an invisible backpack with things that are all about us, that makes us, make us special. And they come very easy because they are gifts that were given to us. you might be all about logic and math, which is very different, because I'm more artistic. That's more who am I, but that's fine. Some of you are very organizational. You like to sort things out. That's really part of who you are. You're very organized, very tidy, everything in their space. And that's who you are, and that's awesome. Some of you might be very good at sports. That's part of who you are. So this week, the first challenge I'm going to ask you is, can you find what is inside of your invisible backpack? What makes you you? What makes you tick? And every time you do it, you feel happy. You feel that it comes easy with you. So let's do that. Anyway, we're going to stop for a moment because I really would like you to come with me and visit the Snoodlesburg, home of the Snoodles. Would you like to come with me? I think they will teach us so much today. Come on. Oh, wow. How beautiful. Can you see how colorful is Snoodlesburg? I'm gonna read you a story that talks about the Snoodles. This story was created by the same authors of VeggieTales stories. They're very good. And I personally love this one. Are you ready? Far, far away! In the land of Galoots, where the Biggleback trees bear their Biggleback fruits, and far lily bushes all blossom in yellow, and thimble plants squirt snowberry jello. Here, where the mountains of Rocky Magoo rise higher in the meadows of Gildam and Dew, where sunsets are painted with purple and blue, you'll find a small town not much bigger than you. Welcome to Snoodlesburg, home of the Snoodles, a curious folk who eat pancakes with noodles and spend half their days making sketches and doodles and cutting their hair into shapes like French poodles. Now, right in the heart of this curious town is a curious building, the tallest around. Look at that. With a clock on its top and a chute at its bottom, it's pink in the spring and turns red in the autumn. But weirder by far than its color or height is what happens every fourth Tuesday night. As strange as it seems, it has been demonstrated that Snoodles aren't born, but rather created. Every fourth Tuesday at 9:15, the town would chimney and rattle and whine. And as the town nibbles on Biggleback fruit, a shiny young Snoodle will drop from its tree. They came from, though no one knows why, nor who could have built the tower so high. These mysteries of life befuddle most Snoodles, who would much rather focus on pancakes and noodles and cutting their head into shapes like French poodles. Yes, must found a tower too noisy and strange until one small Snoodle made all of that change. The little Snoodle was much like the others. He came without siblings, no sisters or brothers. He came without money, no mom or a dad. The peck of his backpack was all that he had.
"This is peculiar,"
the little guy said.
"I came from a chute and I felt on my head. What do I look like? What am I for?"
He pondered those questions and then he thought of more.
"Checking my backpack is a good place to start,"
he He pulled out some paints.
Maybe I'm good at art!
The next thing he found was a snoodle kazoo.
Hey, what do you know? I can make music too!
Then back on his back, he pulled a small string and out from the sides popped two little wings. Look at this! Amazing, he said with a gleam in his eye.
I can paint, play kazoo, and now I can fly. Wait till the others see all the great things I can do with my paintings, my kazoo, and my wings.
So he packed up his paints and his snoodle kazoo and he hopped off to show them all what he could do. There, from atop of a short stubby wall, the big snoodles heard the new small snoodle call.
Come watch me, you guys, as I head to the skies.
He straightened his wings with a gleam in his eye, and he jumped and he flapped like the red snooter finches that fly from the plains to the peak of Mount Kinches. His flight, unlike theirs, covered only 12 inches.
You call that flying?
You think you're a bird?
We've never seen anything quite so absurd.
The old snoodle snorted, he sniggered, he shook.
I'll paint you a picture
to show you how you looked. The brush strokes were skillful, the colors were killish. The story they told made the young one feel foolish.
Take it from us, said a snoodle named Lou.
Fly just ain't what you meant to do.
The young snoodle drooped. He felt his heart sag. The painting the old snoodle placed in his bag.
Carry this with you, the old snoodle said. So visions of flying don't go to your head.
The weight in his bag was as heavy as lead. So under the weight of the picture he bore, he hobbled along feeling lonely and sore. Till up far ahead, on a bench near the tower, he spied a bright bundle of far lily flowers. His heart started lifting.
What beautiful things!
Then he remembered,
I've got much more than wings.
So quickly, he dug the paints out of his pack and hoped that with art maybe it had the knack.
I did it!
He yelled to the snoodles in town, then held up his pictures as they gathered round.
You did it all right, said the snoodles, replying. You showed you're no better at painting than flying.
Then one of them laughed and, while eating a waffle, painted a picture that made him feel awful.
You're puny.
You're silly.
You're not all that smart. You can't use your wings and you're no good at art.
That picture, too, was placed in his back and made his heart slump just as low as his back.
I'm ugly. I'm foolish. I'm so very small. I don't think I should be with snoodles at all.
So he decided to get out of town. His wings hang so low that they dragged on the ground. He walked past the tower and out of the city. He walked through the fields and thought,
my, that's pretty. The fir lily bushes are blooming in yellow and thimble plants squirting snowberry jello. I might like it here, said the small snoodle fellow,
Then feeling some warmth coming back in his chest, he thought he would sit for a moment and rest. But try as he might to sit down with grace, the weight on his back knocked him flat on his face.
"That's a hoot," said a voice from behind. A farmer stood with a thimble fine. "Why, you need a picture, my Snoodleberg bird, lest you forget how you look in a mud."
And so, in an instant, the picture was done and placed in his backpack, which now weighed a ton. The poor Snoodle struggled. He wobbled, he groaned, he stood on his feet, and he said with a moan, "Is there anywhere I can be truly alone?" Just then, overhead, flew two red snooted finches, winging their way toward the peak of Mount Kinches.
"I see," said the Snoodle. "Then that's what I'll do." The help from those finches will be my home too.
So painfully struggling under his pack, the small Snoodle inched up the big mountain's back. He crawled over boulders in rain and in lightning. He trudged on and on, though the journey was frightening. Till finally, on Sunday, at 2:15, he spied all the meadows of Kilimanjoo and realized he was on the top of Mount Kinches, alone with the wind. And his thoughts and the finches, he thought of the Snoodles, he thought of the tower, he thought of the bell that would chime on the hour. He thought on his pack and his very long walk. He thought it so loudly, and he heard his thoughts talk.
"Hello," said his thoughts. "You've made quite a climb."
"That voice," he remarked, "doesn't sound much like mine."
Then he turned and he noticed that he wasn't alone, for a man stood behind near a cave in the stone. He looked like a Snoodle, though quite a bit bigger. Maybe a giant, the small Snoodle figured.
"I'm going,"
the Snoodle boy said with a huff.
"Don't paint any picture, I've got quite enough.
But first, come inside," the man said. "Have some tea. I'm so very pleased that you're visiting me." Let's see what's going to happen. The Snoodle boy stopped. He'd only got inches and stared at the stranger he'd found in Mount Kinches. He didn't seem angry. In fact, he looked kind. The poor little boy was confused.
"Are you blind?" "I'm puny. I'm silly. I'm not all that smart. I can't use my wings, and I'm no good at art."
The stranger leaned down with a pain in his heart.
"Who told you those things?" he asked. "How do you know?"
"These pictures I have in my pack tell me so."
The small Snoodle sniffled and started to go.
"First, if you please, let me look at this art
that makes your pack heavy and weighs down your heart."
Then the poor Snoodle and made his wings sag. "Dear boy," said the man, "this look nothing like you." Then into the fire, picture by picture, he threw. He rose from his chair saying, "Wait there, you'll see that what you need the most is a picture from me."
The snoodle sat patiently, sipping his tea. And then, from a room in the back, he returned and said,
"Dear little snoodle, it's time that you learn what you really look like." And he threw off the sheet. What the boy saw warmed him right to his feet. The boy in the portrait looked older and strong, with wings on his back that were sturdy and long, and a look in his eye, both courageous and free.
"Sir," asked the boy, "are you saying that's me? I'd like to believe it, but sir, I'm afraid to."
"I know you are," the man said, "for I made you. I built the tower and set it into motion. I plant the meadow, put fish in the ocean. I feed the finches, though most snoodles doubt it. Not one of them falls that I don't know about it. I've seen you fall down in the mud and the goo. I've seen all you've done and all that you will do. I gave you your pack and your paints and your wings. I chose them for you. They're your special things. The snoodle kazoo, so you can sing about colors in the autumn or flowers in the spring. I gave you your brushes in hopes that you'd see how using them you could make pictures for me." "Most of the snoodles, the old ones," said sadly, "just use their paints to make others feel badly." The young snoodle pondered the things he'd been told, then wondering something, grew suddenly bold.
"But sir, if you made this incredible land, can't you make snoodles obey your command?"
The big one smiled warmly, then said to the small,
"A gift that's demanded. It's no gift at all." With that, the small snoodle reached to his pack and pulled out the picture that he made 10 miles back.
"They're far lilies, sir, from over the bridge."
The old one beamed bright and said,
"That's for my fridge." After the small snoodle's picture was hung, the old one bent down to the face of the young. And he said, "Here's what you look like. Here's how I see you. Keep it this in your backpack and you'll find it will free you from all the pictures and all the lies that other made up
just to cut down your size.
And lastly, your wings. You know what they're for. Not just to fly. I want you to soar."
"But sir," said the snoodle, "how can I fly? The picture's so big, I won't get very high."
"Oh, but this picture is special. It's bigger, it's brighter. Carry it close, and I think you'll feel lighter." As soon as he heard it, the snoodle looked down and noticed that it was an inch from the ground. He laughed and he leaped and he flew from the cave, feeling now older and stronger and brave. And he flew through the clouds and he flew with the finches. He soared up and down round the peak of Mount Ginches. He flew over the fire lily bushes in yellow and thimble plants squirting snowberry jello. Flew over beagleback trees and their fruits in big lazy loops o'er the land of galoots. Then hurried back home to the center of town where the snoodles all stood with their wings on the ground. And starting precisely at 2:15, he told them the story that I just told you. Did you like this story of the snoodle? Oh, I love it. It really warms my heart to see that sometimes, even that we have the best backpacks, the most amazing gifts in our lives, We can be either using them for bad to hurt others, or we cannot even use them at all because we're afraid. Well, we'll talk a little bit more about this in the next video. Now it's time to think. And my first challenge, like I told you today, it's all about you taking some time to write down, if you can, with your mommy and daddy, what are the gifts I have in my backpack? Those are the things that I can do easily, but most of all, the things that give me pleasure, that bring me joy, and also usually, those things, they will also give pleasure, joy, and feel others happy, the ones that are around us. Sometimes you're going to be very good with words, and you're very good, and you are an encouraging person. The things you say really touch others. That's a gift. Use it. Well, it might be that you're very good at arts or sports or maths or all the things I said, but it might be something completely different. So you need to be quite a detective this week to find out. Write it out and talk with mommy and daddy. And then wait for the second video. I'll talk a little bit more about this story, yes. So at the moment, I'm going to finish my video to tell you again and remind you that you are loved. Please don't forget that you are loved. Have an amazing week. God bless you.